food is huge. Come on, there's mochi, there's the toshikoshi soba you got to do at the stroke of midnight. Right, yeah. So much food is involved. So that's a big cultural thing. Hey everyone, welcome back to another Happy New Year episode. We're the hosts. My name is MJ.
My name is Adam.
Thanks for coming back for another episode where me and Adam speak full English. We invite you to join our conversation to improve your listening and understand the ways of the Western mind, or at least our minds. Today's episode, we're going to be talking about North America versus Japan's New Year's. New Year's is just around the corner, everybody. Hopefully you had a good 2021 because 2022 is just around the corner.
Yep.
And it's celebrated in so many different ways. So today we're going to be talking about North America, me from America, Adam from Canada, what it was like there, good points, bad points. And then in Japan, good points, bad points, and maybe some that we would like to cross over or share that each culture and country could, enjoy.
Yeah.
So, Adam, let's hear it. Good points, bad points about North American, maybe in Canada. It's probably the same.
It's probably the same.
I believe. I
think it's pretty much the same.
The gist of getting together.
Just the getting together. Friends.
You're of age. A lot of drinks.
Yeah, a lot of drinks.
Although
I wasn't one to go out. Like, I always thought that New Year's was like family time, because it always was family time for me. I was always like, let's stay home.
Okay.
Let's play some board games, sometimes Monopoly, sometimes Domino.
Yeah. I had that definitely when I was younger. My family, we had a lot of, relatives living in the same town. So to go to uncle's house to spend the New Year's.
Yeah.
But pretty much after I had my own car, I opted not to go to those, and I would go hang out with my friends.
With your friends.
But, similar like you wouldn't go out. I feel like I would never go out like to a restaurant or to a bar. We would always go to someone's house, and there would be like a bunch of friends, maybe like, you know, 10 friends or something. We went in deep and we heard about like our personal New Year's.
Yeah.
But if we were to rattle off some, like a list of the norm kind of things to do in North America, it would be like, you spend time either with your family or friends, drinking, watching the ball drop.
Fireworks.
There's probably some like events, maybe concerts and stuff, clubs, they have theirs events. The span of the holiday finishes very quickly.
Very quickly.
Right on the second, you're back. Mm-hmm. And then to follow it, and then to continue what you were saying, that's the one point you don't like.
I think that's the only point I don't like, to be honest. Just having to go back the day after New Year's Day. It's like, I just want to relax.
Especially when you're, pounding back those drinks.
Oh, yeah.
And you stayed up until like four, or maybe pulled an all-nighter or something.
Yeah.
Okay. Yeah. So now let's go over to Japan. What are the things that we've seen? What are those normal things that everybody does, the traditional things?
Longer holiday. So eat.
Yep.
Drink.
That's a lot of eating. There is drinking, but I feel like since it's more family-oriented, like that's the traditional thing, I think more people, probably like 90%+ of the people in Japan spend time with their family. They go back to their hometowns and stuff and eat. And of course, people are drinking too, enjoying themselves. But the eating thing, the whole concept of osechi ryori, and we had an episode back in the day where we explained the meanings of all of them. And it's so much going into like fortune to give or to receive fortune for the next year. So it was really important to be eating these foods, these dishes. So that's, food is huge. Come on, there's mochi, there's the toshikoshi soba you got to do at the stroke of midnight. Right, so much food is involved. What else? There is going to the temples or shrines. I always forget which one it is.
Hatsumode.
After.
Fukubukuros, which of course start earlier this year. Previous years as well.
Yes.
That's a big thing, the sales, the
New Year's sales. Yeah. And there is osoji.
Osoji, yep.
Got to clean up the house. You got to do that big clean.
Yeah.
For the New Year's. So cold outside. Especially for everyone living in Hokkaido and, Open Tohoku.
Yeah.
But hey, it's osoji time. Open those windows.
the two events that unfortunately one of them is canceled.
Okay.
Kohaku and Warache Ikenai. Yeah.
So yes, those are another two. And I think recently fighting, like some sort of like boxing tournament or K1, really? That has been another one that has been reoccurring every year. Wow. For the not like celebrating the New Year's, but it's happened for the New Year's. The biggest thing that I don't see is a countdown. That's the TV. One thing. Yeah. Now there are a few places I've heard in Shibuya Scramble the past couple of years before the pandemic started, people would gather at the Scramble and there's like a countdown there, but there's not much focus on it on TV. So like if you're watching Kohaku or if you're watching Warache Ikenai or any of these programs, there's no like stop the clock and like everyone stop, we're doing this live performance, but it's almost 12 ready. Let's, and they all like
ready
do a countdown.
Counting. Yeah. Yeah. It just kind of happens.
I don't see that. Does that happen in people's homes?
I don't know.
I think if the countdown is just like when your Okasan's like, you know, getting the soba ready.
Yeah.
Okay. And when it comes out, then hey, Happy New Year's. So quickly, let's think of things that are you would like to exchange or bring over to another place. Over. So if we were still in North America, what would you bring from the Japanese culture?
Definitely the longer extended New Year's
vacation, break. Winter break. Vacation. Yep.
Although we have Christmas, but I want
we
start early, but finish early. I want to start early and finish late.
Food
would be another big one. The one that I don't want to bring over is everything gets closed and there's no banking and all that stuff gets like locked down for days.
Yes, yes.
Don't want to have that, but I do want to bring in the food culture and having like, you know, meanings to these big meals and just more family time is good with food and that's what I want.
I like the family thing, definitely. Yeah. And I like Hatsumode. And maybe it's just because, you know, with your family, but even with friends, like going out to do this one thing that everybody does, I don't know.
Right.
There's something about it that's like adds to the fun. And especially if you're going to do Hatsumode and you grab, you know, to see your Kuji, to see if you're going to have a lucky year and whatnot.
Yeah. Yeah.
That's another thing that's added to it, which is very fun. And then if we're in Japan and something that we want to bring over, what would it be?
The countdown, like doing that with everybody.
Yeah.
Be cool. It makes you feel like a New Year's actually happening. Something
turn of the clock,
like to celebrate, to turn the clock.
It's there like sometimes, but like
it's not like
usually like I'll flip over to like NHK when they're at a shrine and you know they start hitting the bell 108 times to ring in the new year. It's just like super quiet, everyone's cold, and then you start boom, and then the MCs are just like Happy New Year.
Okay.
Yeah. So it's a little lackluster. So I would like to bring the big bang.
Ring it in.
Ring it in. Hey, we have a website called the MJ and Adam Show. You can download our episodes like a podcast. Hey, you can even join me every day on Facebook. I'm doing live streams explaining interesting words and phrases we use in all of our episodes.
You can join us every month on Zoom. We have a meetup where all of the members of the Next Step community come together. We talk, we share laughs, share stories, and just hang out. It's a great time.
And if you want to take your English even further to the next step, you can join me one-on-one with English online lessons. It doesn't matter if you are a beginner, intermediate, advanced, come join me. And through English conversation, I want to help you improve your conversation. All right, everyone. Well, that's it for this episode. Let us know in the comments down below, what is something that you like about the New Year's in Japan, the culture of it? What would you recommend for other countries to kind of take part in? Or if there's something that you've heard from another country, maybe not even the North America, some interesting New Year's tradition that another country has, let us know in the comments. All right, everyone. Thanks again. That's it. We'll see you on the next step.